Okay, Kadra, Tears, as I'm sure you're aware, there's been an update to CS Global Offensive, and they've introduced some new guns, which are the Autosnipers, and a new one in casual mode called the Zeus X27. I thought what I'd do is I'd quickly put a video together so you could have a look at them and see how they handle. I'm going to give you a little preview here because they handle pretty much like they do in Source. So what we'll do is we'll quickly just restart this game. I've got the bots on knife only because that's the only way I'd be able to kill them otherwise, because obviously I'm old and bad at games. And what we'll do is we'll just quickly take it into the mid area and see how it handles. So auto snipers, typically accurate and jumping. You can see they've still got this lens blur on here. Let's see where they're at. Oh. Bye. That's pretty accurate with no scope in there, I think we can see.
Two to go.
Counter terrorists win. So we'll just take it for another run through. See what we can do with it. We'll go along this time, try and get some jumping headshots, which I know are always a source of comedy in this particular title.
Tunnel, he's got the bomb. On my way.
Supremely accurate there. So, not as accurate when you're unscoped. But it feels a lot like the, you know, kind of auto snipers we've seen. This, you know, movement speed when you've got it out slows you right down to about the same speed, I'd say. And in terms of how it handles, it's pretty much on the money. So, not very exciting, really. I'm surprised as well at the sort of level of scope blur you get on it. Like, if you look, the slightest bit of movement and it really sort of starts to blur a little. But I mean, that just seems to be a feature in the game. It doesn't really seem to be affecting accuracy or anything like that. It just seems to kind of, you know, occlude your vision, if you like. It doesn't really impact on you know, how the sort of gun behaves. So beat me to it with the shank.
But,
oh, hello. Yeah, it feels to have an almost slower rate of fire as well, a little bit more sluggish. So it's sort of like the CT auto sniper, you know, but a little bit different. Anyway, that's a CT one. We'll quickly jump over to T. Okay, so here we are on the T side. Going to take the G3 SG1 for a test drive. See how that goes. Through there. Right. And you can see how it's different from the CT one immediately. It feels a lot meatier than the CT one. It feels a lot meatier than the one in Source even as well. Straight away, the way it, the recoil on it, the noise on it, seems to make a real sort of big kind of sound, and there's quite a kick to it. So I'll just scope down mid again, see if we can get any picks on the door. Highly unlikely. So see if anyone crosses. Of course not, because they're bots. They won't be doing anything like that, will they? No. All rush long, isn't it? Well, at least we've tried the nose ghost out. And that's pretty brutal. So, no scope in accuracy feels a little bit better than the SCAR 20. Let's say rate of fire seems to be higher. And headshots still kill, so it's pretty you know, again, straightforward, almost a direct clone of sorts. I mean, I would say that the feel of it is very different, and I think there's a bit more of a jump, like, which is noticeable when you shoot. We'll try some jumping stuff. I want to see what the jumping accuracy is like, so...
I'm gonna wait here.
My band of knife-happy brothers. Probably from Glasgow. And yep, been stood up. I will go this way. And T-spawn, are they? You bots. You wily, wily bots.
Way to go.
Oh, well, I got shanked, but I got two of them. Jumping actually, it feels a little bit better, I would say, than the CT-1. But again, in terms of how it handles, that's a notable difference, that the jumping accuracy isn't 100% the same as it is in Source, because you could literally do jumping headshots no problem at all with an auto sniper. So the auto snipers that have been incorporated into the game pretty much are as Source. I wouldn't say they handle very different at all, really, but they have got a good meaty kind of physicality to them. They're pricey, they're more expensive than an AWP, as always was the case, and whether or not, again, we'll see them incorporated into this new meta game which is going to develop, I don't know. But what we're going to take a look at now is the Zeus X27, which is a game that's only available in casual mode. It's not really relevant to the competitive side of things, but obviously you guys, some of you will just be playing casually, so we'll take a look at it anyway. Okay, so you may remember that when we were doing all the coverage of the CSS Pros going out to Seattle, you may have heard talk of tasers. And people were saying, well, what the hell is this? And here it is. This is the modified version of the Tazer gun, the Zeus X27. This won't feature in competitive play now, but it's a one-shot stun gun. I'm going to... There it is. Bang. Zip. And you can see him just twitching there. He's twitching. He probably wet himself. It'd be nice if there was a little puddle coming out. Hello? But yeah, so that's the that's the Tazer, the Zeus X27. Basically, just one shot, it instantly disables a target, and they stay down. I mean, they're effectively dead for the purposes of the game. So it's not a big deal. It's not going to be in competitive play, but it's certainly something that they've left in there from when, like I said, these pros went over to Seattle and presented with the first game. And I think, I know, it's a bit of fun, and why the hell not, you know? I mean, you can imagine now you're going to get...